Go.
And I'm feeling.
I gotta actually, yeah, I gotta set up my chore.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, there we go. All right, finally. Thing's been a massive pain in the ass today. Why is Steam always like, open Steam to open game? No, just open the fucking
Oh
game from the desktop. Why have all that
yeah.
extra when that we already have the icon on the desktop? Come on, man. Get your shit together, Steam. All right.
Switch over the USB over here to the Xbox so I can keep charging my headphones, plug in my microphone.
And I'm gonna put in my music. Give me one sec.
And I'll change the Spyro skin color to green.
Oh, nice.
Feels good to be back in streaming, guys. Not gonna lie.
Put my charger on my
I'll say
laptop.
what the new series will be starting Monday as at the end of this stream. Hey, thanks, Chef.
There you go.
Appreciate you, bud. How's the audio, by the way? I've been tweaking it all morning.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Thank you for the good luck. Good
Sounds
luck,
good to me
gentlemen.
from
Give me
this
one
end.
sec to set up my music. I'm gonna set it really fucking low
Oh yeah, I
so
gotta
that
close out
I
the
can
world.
still hear you guys, but this way I can still listen to my tunes. There we go.
Fair enough.
Right on.
Let's do. Yeah, let's do Sanctus. Extra room.
My pass.
That's the wrong one. Oof. Me. Kind of scarfed down my food.
Someone's got the hiccups. Hold your breath. Let's say if you've got hiccups, hold your breath. Hold your breath for five, burn 10 seconds, and breathe out again. Normally works for me.
It made my headache worse, but they're gone. Eat a spoon of sugar.
Right. There's a
Fair.
million different
Also, hi 420.
theories on how to
So,
cure the hiccups.
if you guys, while you guys are prepping, if you guys don't mind me going into what's been going on for a few minutes. So essentially, I appreciate everyone who supported my hiatus for a
Of
few
course.
days.
Okay, man, take your time.
I got very tragic news about 5 days ago going on. Seems like it's already been a week. Me and my brother Patrick's are one of our closest and oldest friends, Billy, very sweet man. He took his own life. The circumstances led up to it make it even more fucking tragic because the more we're hearing about it, the more it sounds like he was played to the point where he had no other way out. As a result, me and my brothers, my family and my friends, we've all been kind of reeling from the whole experience. We even reconnected with friends that we haven't talked to in over 10 years, which was really awesome. That aspect, at least. And so I just took a few days to kind of process. I wanted to return yesterday, but my wife, thankfully talked me out of it and said, no, actually give yourself time to mourn. I'll be honest, I'm not going to be 100% for a while. I'm not going to be like, hey guys, or anything. You know me, I don't put on a charade or anything. But if I'm a little quiet for the next few streams, I apologize. It's just I'm still stuck in
No,
my
no.
head about the old thing. There's actually more and more information coming out about it that he may not have been on the up and up, which is even more heartbreaking, is like I said, me and my brothers looked up to him as an older brother. So, yeah. And as I mentioned when I started the stream, I will say what the next series we're doing starting Monday is. I'm really excited about it because it's currently a game I'm very close to platinuming in my free time. But with all that said and done, rest in peace, Billy. We love and miss you, buddy. And yeah, if you guys would like to introduce yourselves, I'd appreciate it. Hi, Indian. Hi. Hello, hello, my friend.
I'm GamingMad92.
And I'm Wade the Pwn.
Yeah. We're gonna close that.
I'm currently the grunt.
Yeah.
In the chat.
Also, hi, Indian Ruben. It says you're a new time streamer. It's very nice to meet you. Welcome to the stream. Sorry you met. We met on such a somber note. I'm okay. You know, I'm starting to feel better. Ty, bring up the mood. Essentially, when I reconnected with my friends, these are friends that Thomas and I have known for going on 20 years. Like, they long time friends. It went from being one of the most tragic days of my life to one of the best. I know, weird way to say something like that. Because I got to hang out with them, and as a result, we're in constant communication, we're checking up on each other. You know, it's just good to talk to them again. These were some of my very, very first friends when we were kids. So there is, like, a silver lining is that the grief has brought us all back together. And it turns out one of them has lived 5 minutes away from me this whole time, and neither of us knew, so yeah. But, the takeaway that I'm getting from it is... And I say this whenever I lose someone, and you might have noticed, I lose people frequently, right? The takeaway I'm taking away from it is that, yes, it's sad that they're gone and that they're never coming back, but I don't want to bawl my eyes out in remorse, right? I want to, more than anything, laugh in tears of joy just at the good times we had together and just appreciative that I got to know them as long as I did. And I realize that somehow that can come off as cold, but it's just a way I've had to handle mourning. I lost 15 people at once a few years ago. What happened to your back? Including an ex-lover. So it's just my way of processing grief. As my grand return to streaming, we're starting with something nice and fun for everybody to have some fun and just chill, listen to my favorite music. Oh, good news. I got Brit into my second favorite band of all, Saint Asonia, my fiance. I love it. That's the album I'm listening to, Flawed Design. But, yeah, once again, thank you sincerely for all of your support. And, yeah, let's hop into it. Let me get back to the music. And, yeah, please, if you can, hit exclamation MT and please go follow Leading Gaming. They're incredible friends of mine and pretty damn good runners, I might say. But yeah, let's hop into it. Who would like to do the countdown? I am not using splits.
Thank you.
Yeah. And apologies.
Hang on, I gotta get out of here.
If it sounded like I was... Yeah, but I'm heading back to work from lunch break. I'll catch with you later. Alrighty, Thomas. Good luck on the rest of your shift. And if it sounded like I was fighting tears saying all that, I was. It's still, you know, relatively new in my head, so just gonna take it well. But yeah, thank you guys. Are we going on go or one?
Just need to get rid of that. I don't need that on there, thank you very much. I'm pretty much good. I'm good to go on go when everyone's ready.
Yeah, so it'll be a 3-2-1 go, like always.
As all right. Of course.
Yep.
Alright.
All ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
I'll tell you what, shall I count it down for us?
Go for it.
Right. Well, so go on go as always. Three. Right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, go.
I think I can turn it up on this.
Alright.
I think I could turn my music up on my headphones. No, I turn it down instead. My brain. It's just mush. This is all mush up here.
Alright, let's get it.
Yeah. Get it. Also, if you guys have music requests and you don't like what you're hearing, let me know. I can just pause it and switch the music. I'm a huge fan of Saint Asonia and early 3 Days Grace, so I've just been listening to a lot. It's also just a good band to listen to when you're mourning. It's got very positive, uplifting messages. Especially since Adam, the singer, has been through a lot of shit himself. Also, I think this song he did with Lizzie Hale. So yeah. You found out Windows 11 has good audio mixing features. I'm not upgrading yet. I don't trust it, man. It gave my computer cancer. I don't want to. I mean, to be fair, that was last year, though, so maybe they finally fix it. How's the audio quality between my voice and the music, Chef? Is it more balanced today? There we go. Audio mix well, yeah. Okay, good. I've been wanting to tweak that to make the experience a little more enjoyable for peeps. Yeah. You can have a game. You can have gameplay through speakers and music through headphones, for example. I mean, that is good, but that's gonna put Voice Meter Banana out of business then, because that's the main reason people use it. I'll see what my buddy Tech God says. If he says that's safe, then yeah, I'll install it. The update. It's like, hey, your computer's compatible. It's like, yeah, guess what? You almost killed it. This is August day, I believe. Yeah. Windows 11 isn't compatible with older computers, though. My computer's from 2020, I think, so it should be fine. It keeps up with PS5, so.
Yeah, it should be good. It's only 3 years.
Damn it.
It's only 3 years up.
Flag got me. Damn! Okay. Maybe Steve Pibble rock pieces that can't upgrade to 11. Yeah. Well, from what I understand, Windows 11 is more a quality of life kind of thing, in terms of its in terms of what the upgrade is. I don't think it actually does anything too major. You're resetting? I honestly might, because I fucked up the thief. Yeah, let's do this.
Right, sorry, resetting.
Damn. I guess I might as fucking yell.
Well, I slipped off. Trying to chase the bastard.
No, I don't want to upgrade live splits. Fuck off, live splits. One like you. The downside is, let's see what she said. So the downside is Windows 10 is going to skip receiving security updates. Yeah. I've got a pretty good antivirus thing. Hence why I'm able to do what I do, but yeah, I'm kind of worried about that because it's going to get to a point where it's going to purposely miss things. Oh, there we go. Like, for instance, Avira, in order for it to work to full capacity, you have to pay for the membership. You can't just clear out all the dead files, you know, on the trial, so I'm worried those are going to pile up. You got this, man.
Right, this one's for real. Come on.
Do it this
one. Oh, I'm firing up, I'll tell you that. I was doing some practice. I was doing a little practice earlier. See how far I can. See how long it will take me to get up to the end of Beastmakers for a laugh.
Yeah.
I managed to get there at buddy. What was it?
56:14. The fastest I've ever gotten through 14, Beastmakers 56, is exactly 14. 58 minutes.
I got up there too.
And
I was like,
I've never been able to surpass that time. Where the fuck are you going? There you go. What? It's 58? Yep, there we go. Okay, now we got
this. Crap. Ooh, that was so lucky.
So would you...
I'll tell you,
go ahead, man. It's fine. This is all for fun. I figure we all could just use a chill race after all the shit going on lately.
Yeah, it's gonna be a chill day for me. I'm not expecting a PB.
Appreciate you guys inviting me to this, by the way. Thank you.
It could happen. I mean, I've had some PBs on chill days before.
And what I was going to say was, I'm not expecting to get a PB, but the only time I'll start treating it like a PB is when if I touch down a nasty nork.
Yeah.
And I know exactly what my PB is at the moment. That's when
Brit,
I'm
right. What you making?
I'm going to go quiet. Go quiet and go for it.
Hey, Thorntrap, thank you and good luck. I'm about to get loose.
Can I have two?
In a second.
Thank you, honey. But yeah, I wanted to treat you a little bit. You've had a rough go of it lately, too. Goddamn fucking thief. Got him. Yeah, Brittany doesn't like meat, but she'll eat shrimp and fish. Which, I guess they're different? Yeah. I don't get it.
Shrimp.
There. Oh, yeah.
Shrimp sounds really
Thankfully,
good
Thankfully, our
right
Schnooks
now
does actually know how to season their food.
But it's all hill.
Nice. It's 110
well, I mean,
here.
It, I would put it on the grill myself if I could.
Right, that's...
Shrimp.
I mean, I can do it. I'm just, like I said, that shit's expensive.
Schnooks has these things called easy meals, which is like these brown bags with meat, with food you just have to heat up. And they're really fucking good. Hey, Eggs, how you doing, sis?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah?
That's exactly what it is.
Sounds like
it's fucking delicious, mate. Oh shit.
Yeah, I've never heard of it before.
I'll just send you a picture too. I mean, it's delicious.
You'll have to type it in Discord later.
They're like $8 to $10, and they're full blown fucking meals. You get full portions. It's amazing.
When I'm at the store.
Eyeshadow.
I swear it'd be a lot cheaper. It'd be a lot cheaper than obviously, say if you've had a stressful day at work and whatever else lead or whatever, you just bang one in the microwave. Lovely.
Oh, I keep pretty simple things to make
Real
at the house,
was...
you know, just for my lazy days. Mm-hmm. Like, I got Chef Boyardee out the ass.
Real Panda was just simply a stand-in for
I
my
got
son, Chef.
Tostitos pizzas in the freezer,
because Jet is
you know?
Who I based Spyro Being Black off of. And Shadow is the little kitty cat that you guys can interact with. It's just something fun for you guys to play around with. You guys do get to change his color by leveling him up, though, so you can give him, like, rainbow fur, which is really cool. Yeah, that's why I got him. I was like, hey, I want something interactive for the viewers to be able to play around
with. I didn't know you
with.
Could play with the
and,
cat
And I saw it on Twitch.
Chat.
Yeah. You can feed him, you can give him water, you can play with him. He plays rock, paper, scissors.
I didn't know it was
beats me every goddamn time. You want
beats you, beats you every time. Sounds like our fucking claw machines.
Eggs, I ask that you don't do that once, Eggs, and still just...
beat you
every... Morning. Bye. Because she said the Sing Redeem is cheaper. I'm like, nope. Oh, excuse me. Man, I don't even got enough. I reduced it for the charity stream, and then that was 2 months ago now, so I just need to turn that off. Or put it back up to 20,000 again, because that's what it was originally at. This song is with Sully Erna from Godsmack. It's called The Hunted. It's so good. He's such a chill fucking dude.
I like Sully.
We'll speed this up. We can get him. Yes! Perfect cycling on the fucking bull in the Matador. Finally! I never get perfect cycling on that. Town Central. Or Central Square, something like that.
Where you
Town Square,
at?
Yeah. Sorry, English doesn't like me today.
Town Square.
Ghost. There we go. Yate. Let's clear as much of this area over here as possible. Run back. Finish it off. You're out of Town Square already? Damn.
Town Square
GG.
Out.
Apparently, I'm behind on my splits.
I've already done stoned him as well.
They're fucked up. sadly, I'm gonna practice square three with splits in
my sleep. My splits are gonna be hard to beat.
I can't, sorry, lead. I can't believe I'm Diamonds
very
and
Kentucky Cats,
but
in
Race Wars is not on the GDQ page.
Yeah.
I tried to watch last night, and I think I was John Duncan last night.
I don't agree with that shit, because that's fucking manipulation, honestly.
I had to
honestly.
Follow just to be able to chat. So, yeah. I was trying to wish Toasted Cat good luck against Deo, and
yep.
But after I followed, I had to wait 10 minutes before.
My
I
whole
could
thing
chat.
Is just that they over-censor their
like,
competitors,
you had to be a follower
their runners.
For 10 minutes before.
Like
you
a guy
do
said
anything.
Shit by accident, almost got kicked out of the event midway through a run. And I'm just like, are you kidding?
Oh, another thing. Mm-hmm. Another one thing was I was trying to wish Toasted. You know, some luck and say don't forget I got a bet riding on this.
But you could be talking about making a bet specifically for the cause of charity.
They got
man.
Deleted.
What the fuck? Yep.
I mean, literally the word bet got deleted. I don't know, I was like, how
well,
fucking
the- To a degree, I understand the censorship because it's an event that's supposed to be all ages, you know, family, children, young children, you know, I get that aspect, but kids hear the word bet all the time. It's not...
Yeah, but
yeah,
see,
exactly.
children bet all the time, I bet you won't do it, you know. I mean, good God.
So, lead, I have to ask
Figured.
You this. If you know
Toasted hasn't
know
really
it,
been racing very often lately.
Who won?
Deoman won.
Deoman's been going head-to-head with Lumi Laura, like, fucking crazy record-wise.
Deoman, that's my boy.
123, goddamn.
Alright,
we're still
good.
Huh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna catch up in, Peacemaker, because I have to get routing used. Oh, and as for why I got those three gems immediately after I teleported back.
124.7.
I noticed that going for those three gems before those two Rhinox was fucking me up. So I decided to just get those first as soon as I teleport back. And it actually does save me a little bit of time because I can just turn around, get the dragon, get those two gems, and then go to the flight. Is it close?
Oh, by the way, lead, was it close at all?
I don't know. I was so pissed off at GDQ.
People say
for,
shit
like,
in the chat all the time, but really,
deleting
that's
my,
not censored.
My message for the word bet that I just left. I literally just left. I was like,
how
you know what, fuck it. I had a good talk with
how
Toasted
are they, by the way?
And,
I love those guys.
2 Chainz last night, you know, on voice chat. So, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, they're doing great, and they're real fun to hang out with in voice chat.
I'll have to come say hello.
Oh, you should sometime. Yeah, you just have to get on Toasted Cat's server on Discord.
Beast.
And that's very easy. You just go to Toasted Cat's channel, type in exclamation point.
Finally,
Discord.
I got the jump first try. God damn it! Okay. So I have what I call Einstein complex, where simple things escape my grasp, but I can do advanced things, and that's actually the definition of it. I couldn't do that skip for the fucking longest for some reason, and yet I can do some of the more advanced skips in like Spyro 2 and 3. It was driving me nuts, so I said, fuck it, took some time, spent 10 to 15 minutes practicing that jump, and I figured it out. You don't charge dump. You do the thing where you use the momentum of charge to get far enough ahead, and then you jump with that momentum. You don't charge over it, even though you do that in fucking Cliff Town. So it fucking surprised me how different those two skips are. If you would even call it a skip. When you get the key in Dark Hollow, and you can jump straight up to that dragon. Yeah,
I'm not sure which
it's so tricky!
About.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because you go, you can go to the bottom first, yeah.
Fair.
I don't do that. I go for the dragon, then go for
I'm
the key.
I'm learning them.
That's what I do.
Wait, you guys suck at boosted jumps? Alright, then yeah, another reason you'll love Spiral 3 is you get flutter jumps.
Them just to
it makes
them.
Those jumps much more manageable, and you can time it better. It gives us the ability to do what's known as perfect hover, which,
yeah.
Ask any runner of Spiral 3, OG, and Reignited, it's one of the best things to ever come out of the Spiral series, mechanic-wise. It's beautiful. You can quote that white guy on YouTube. Nice. Can never figure out his fucking name. Does anyone know who I'm talking about? Because I probably sound like a maniac if not. He's like a British dude on YouTube, really skinny.
I have no idea.
GG. I'm entering Toasty right now.
I don't know, but Dark Hollow out.
Remember, faster loading screens too, so I have that advantage. Damn, I'm on 910. I'm just doing Toasty, and then going to PC
first. After Toasty, or are you going straight?
Yeah.
So this is the song I got Brittany into. It's called Beast, and for anyone who's been like a long-time fan of Three Days Grace, Adam Guns here, the singer, confirmed that this song is a part two to Animal I Have Become, a very famous Three Days Grace song in which he talked about his battle with addiction. And so this song is basically him saying, "I've overcome it, and I will continue to do so." And I'm like, okay, I like that message. Yeah. I get a lot of shit for listening to like Three Days Grace and Disturbed because of the messages in the music, and it's
That's
like,
cool.
Are you kidding me? It's wholesome. How are you gonna shit on me for that? Yeah. Very sweet, man.
A lot of people don't
hope he's getting better, man. That guy is getting hit hard for life.
David Ryan.
Shit. There we go. Fuck you, Glitch Dog. You didn't get me that time. Die. There we go. I just wanted to kill him because he pissed me off. Things you can say in a video game, but not in real life. Holy shit. What? Things you can say in video games, but not in real life?
Now, that would be a fun video to do.
I was going to ask you guys about that. I want to branch out from gaming as well. Would you guys like to do content creation with me?
Oh.
Just fun little videos we can all do together.
Yeah,
it doesn't have to be anything specific. We can do music, video games, honestly anything. I also want to start reviewing movies because I'm a huge film buff.
Yeah. I mean, we can do like a Wacky Wednesday or a Trivia Tuesday, It doesn't always have to be Spyro or video games. There's a lot of people
you and I are both trained chefs, so we can go into culinary
that
stuff.
That aren't video game related.
Yeah.
I do want to do some cooking streams in the future.
I will literally get you guys a plane ticket to
come
visit just to hang out with
you
guys. Because it would be awesome to meet you guys.
Bottom.
Yeah.
Bottom.
Sorry,
I'll do that one day.
Well, sorry. Just to let you guys know. Honestly, I've in high
good
caves,
god dude, your tone scared me. I thought you were gonna give me
changed,
bad
I've
news
changed, in high caves,
like,
I've changed
nah,
back
man,
to my,
awesome.
My
old
room.
Don't tell me something bad happened to you too.
No.
Sorry guys, I can't take any more.
I'm just going back to my old room in
that,
high caves. I'm just so I just
let me guess, you can't get the wall glide?
Little...
I can teach you how to do that. There's a trick to it.
I can't get used to it.
That's only if you want to. I'm not going to be like, hey, I'm going to teach you this, even though you didn't ask me. No, that's... You know what I mean. You want to learn it, let me know. If not, that's fine too. Just anything to make the runs more enjoyable for all of us.
Oh, yeah.
No, if I may go into a little bit of like what happened. I won't go into details, right? Because obviously what happened to him doesn't need to be said publicly. It was pretty fucked up. One of the reasons why I took it so hard when I found out about the suicide was I pride myself on being able to help people and quote-unquote save lives. Long story short, I don't take credit for the people I help because the way I want them to look at it is it was their own fucking strength that got them through all of that, and then I just encourage them to use that strength. That's the way I look at it, because I feel like, you know, if you take that victory from them, you know, that's not cool. And so, as someone who prides himself on saving lives, the reason why Billy's suicide hit me so hard, again, he's an older brother, but also, I couldn't reach out to him. I couldn't save him. And that shit hit me like a freight train more than pretty much any other aspect of it. Got it. Oi! Context, I have an organization where we work with stuff like that, and we want to expand to political, racial, and world issues, but yeah, that's one of the reasons why it hit me, is like, that was the first thing. It's like, the weirdest thing is, I was thinking of contacting for the past week or so, right? I was like, hey, you know, I haven't heard from him in a while, because you can ask my fiance, I was talking about him recently, Billy, and I was like, hey, I'll reach out to him, and I completely fucking forgot. And so it's like that feeling, it's like, would things have been different if I contacted him? You know what I mean? The woulda, coulda, shoulda aspect of it is what drives you insane. But the way I look at it is, he was fighting some demons, you know? We all fight our own battles underneath the surface. I don't think there's much I could have done, honestly. It sounds like... it just sounds like he lost his battle. And I want to make something very clear. When it comes to subjects as serious as suicide, I want people to know one thing. The way to look at someone committing suicide isn't, oh, you know, fuck them, or, oh, you know, they hurt me or anything. It's, they lost their battle with depression. It is a heavy fight, and not everyone makes it out the other side. So, please, from the bottom of my heart, I ask anyone, if you find out one of your friends is suicidal, do not make it about yourself. Ask them why they're feeling this way. Put yourself in their shoes, not the other way around. That alone will help so many more people than you think. Even therapists and psychiatrists fail to do that most of the time. Like, I hear, when I was going through my own battle with depression, what I would hear is, oh, but you're, you know, this is how it's impacting us, and us, or, you know, you're affecting these people this way. It's like, but it's not about them. It's about how you yourself are feeling. So I just want people to look at it through that perspective. It's because if you do, we can help more people that way.
Yeah.
Show them that they matter. Yeah. But that's all I wanted to say on it. Sorry. I won't harp on it too much because, again, fun stream, trying to take my mind off of all of it. But I hope that advice helps. And for anyone going through depression, just know you're not alone. Yeah. There are literally millions around the world that are going through exactly what you're going through for the most part. And all it takes is reaching out. And I wish you the best of luck with the battles you fight under the surface, because even though I don't see them, I believe in you. I'm fighting my own at the moment, honestly. But yeah, my bad. Go ahead.
as you said, like, R&P. As you say, you're not alone, just like Michael Jackson, sending his hit.
It's not bad.
Yeah.
Hey.
That was an impression of Michael Jackson, by the way. If I could, if I could do it at full power, it would have to be the way you make me feel. But I could only do that at full power. Well, unfortunately, I cannot. I'm pretty well. I'm well known for it, but that's one song I reckon I could do in karaoke.
No, you sure could. I recently beat my dad. If anyone's ever seen the Phantom of the Opera, without I was able to sing on key Phantom or Music of the Night, and I beat my dad by like 50,000 points on SingStar. I was happy about that, man. He's an incredible musician. I beat him. Yes. Boy, that is all I'm gonna say. Out of just respect, we're trying to keep the streams nice and mellow. That is the last I will say on what happened. Also, just because I'm mainly trying not to think about it myself, to be honest.
Oh, get up there.
Yeah. But if anyone wants to ask me questions about it later, that's fine. I have a Discord, I have an Instagram, Facebook, Whole Nine Yards. But I will not disclose the information publicly because it's pretty fucked up. Like, I don't even think I told you guys what happened, as far as I remember. Mm-hmm. Follower goal, your goal... Oh, shit. Thank you for the follow, Andy. I appreciate you.
You told me what was going on, and,
thank you for the follow. Love you, appreciate you. Welcome to the family. I forgot what my thing was. Damn.
Did you fall? I was going to say, Lee, did you unfollow what's her name last night?
Who's that? Oh, you're talking about Snellica.
Yeah.
No, I didn't even go check her out yet.
She was streaming earlier, but...
That's fair. No judgment,
between,
man.
The stage between us, she was stoned.
Oh, I'd rather fun. People... Okay, let me put you this lot. Way. As weird as this sounds, I'd rather people get stoned than drink soda.
Oh, sorry.
Because weed has no negative side effects on your body, but soda will actually increase your chance for, like, really bad conditions. So if I find out my friends are stoners, but they don't, like, smoke cigarettes or anything, no offense.
I'm just drinking water.
I'd rather it be that, you know?
Bacon.
Congratulations, man.
I've stuck to my three cigarettes a day now for nearly 3 months.
I appreciate it. I actually do have British family.
I don't know what that was.
The majority of my dad's very good British accent. You can't do a British accent with shit, though, which I find funny. It's adorable because he was trying to the other day. The fucking thief got me. Well, the problem is, everybody seems to think that when it comes to British accents, what people do is they try to imitate, like, Harry Potter. And I'm like, it's close, but no. That, the same thing with the Irish, people seem to think we sound like fucking leprechauns.
Those are a little bit over-exaggerated, to be honest.
Hyper-flamboyant.
Well, just
yeah.
Like when they try to imitate gay people.
My best friend, my closest and oldest friend, D'Anthony,
is
hyper-flamboyant as fuck. He is gayer than a two-bar bill, and he wears it on his sleeve with pride, and I love him for it. But he pointed out that he hates that that's the only representation that they get.
Now, I do know people that have that kind of voice, and you know, I'm not hating on it, but I hate it when it's like, on TV, Brittany... and that's literally every like that's just how you know they're gay.
Yeah, like for instance, the now, reboot modern, or the continuation that '90s show or 2000 show. I think what is it called, Brett? The continuation of that '70s show that just came out. That '90s show. Okay.
About the 90s show.
Because I know they tried to do it, like, what, 20 years ago?
Yeah.
Was it good, at least?
No.
Gotcha. Oh, and I need to correct some information, because I was actually completely wrong. So...
No.
I had no idea that the Futurama reboot that's coming out on Hulu is not the same one as the one that was coming out on HBO Max. So... For anyone not in the know, there was a huge controversy about HBO Max not bringing back the original cast. Well, apparently, Hulu's answer to that was doing their own reboot where they brought back everyone. And the coolest part about this, it continues after the Time Button episode. So, Leela and Fry actually are a couple, which I thought was really sweet. Because good God, man, they had them doing the what will they, won't they for what? The entire series? Something like that? And that, like, Futurama is one of my favorite adult cartoons. So I was really happy to see that that's coming back with new episodes, but even more that it brought back the original cast. Yeah!
Hey,
what have you heard so far?
I'm more interested into the new King of the Hill series coming out on Hulu.
I can't stand
a game theory?
All I can tell you is that there's just theories on it. You know, people say
that
it's going to be
for the fact
future.
That they kind of hinted that Bill may,
you know, people say
may or may not
be
Bobby's father. Because that fucked me up when I first saw that. Yeah, exactly. I just think that was really fucking weirdly specific.
I don't,
like, oh, yeah,
nah,
here's a little
Hank
hint that he may or may not be Bill's kid. Because if you look at Cotton, Bobby looks just like Cotton. Hank's dad.
Yeah, exactly.
There's an anime series I used to watch, a secret spy anime series I used to watch called it's called Archer.
I hate Lana though. I hate Lana for how she treated Archer about their kid though. I don't think I could ever forgive her for that.
Excellent.
Yeah. So okay, does the daughter know Archer is her father? That's what I fucking want to know, because that's where I left off. Bob Benjamin. He also sounds like my old science teacher from high school. Archer. Literally,
does Bob's Burgers? You know.
He's also apparently super chill.
That dude just has a good voice for animated characters.
Haven't you seen the whole lot?
Brittany, what's these? We left off when they brought in the two.
Have you seen all the episodes of
the two ladies? I forget their names. Archer, what season did we leave off on? It was the one where Archer had befriended a monkey in Africa. Like a baby chimp. And they introduced these two new characters who I thought were a couple, but no. And basically they were like the new comic relief extra characters that were kind of ham-fisted in. And that was like the last episode I saw. So if that helps, that's the last episode. So probably 5 seasons? There.
Probably not. All I can say is I've watched all of them.
I've watched bits and pieces of certain episodes. I liked it when I was watching it, but I never really had the time to like just get invested into a season or like
binge
watching.
No, the one we're watching right now
like
is Cowboy Bebop, because I've never seen it all the way to the end. If it ends the way I've been told it ends, I'm going to be pissed, because I really like the main character.
I can't finish it.
I think Stephen Bloom is basically Spike Spiegel himself, to be honest. I think he fit the role of the character perfectly. I'll show you later. Definitely not stream.
I don't even know
definitely.
Where I can watch Cowboy Bebop anymore.
Do you have a computer? Can it stream? All right. All right, then I have a website for you to use.
Of course.
There we go.
Yeah, it can stream really well.
I'm going to start using it for watch parties on the Discord if we can get enough interactivity. That was the other thing, guys. If you want to see, because I've been getting a lot of requests to bring back like movie night that I used to do on the Discord. If you guys want to see that, please let me know, because I am considering it bringing it back. It's just we didn't have enough interactions in the community to do so. So I canceled it completely. But I do want to do it again. It was really fun whenever we could get people. So we basically started with Supernatural and Steven Universe, just like two very popular shows at the time. But we're pretty much open to anything. I know I want to start Gravity Falls at some point, because I think it'd be a really cool like mystery series for the channels to watch together. The only thing I I'll make a rule about is like Walking Dead. Because that's one that you would have to sit down for months to be able to get through. Yep. I also just really hate it.
Oh yeah, I mean 10 seasons, right? Or was it 11? I can't remember.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed it in the beginning, because I'm a diehard like. End of the world shit is literally my kind of like my genre. I love
maybe behind
shit.
By like a few seconds. God damn it. How do you skip Tubby's cutscenes, by the way?
But
yeah.
Oh, who are you talking about, Shemp?
Really?
You just jump up on the platform before you grab the dragon.
I'm just
okay.
Basically.
Yeah, I'm gonna be behind for like a minute.
Run the circle.
Would you guys
just
TV right
like...
now?
Yeah, I hit that chest right before the dragon, and then I jump up on his platform, and then jump back down and grab the dragon. That skips his cutscene.
Nice.
Matter of fact, I got a really good.
I need to work on
just a second ago.
I need to work on routing peacekeepers better. Because don't get me wrong, it's fucking fast, but it's nowhere near fast enough. Also, should I give a hint about what the new series is?
Right.
All right.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Damn.
I think you should.
I'm just going...
Just,
before you do that, I'm just that going to Dr. Shemp
now
with an IGT of 1957.
That's incredible.
What the fuck is going on?
I'm entering Ice Cavern with 2216. Wait, actually,
what the
that's
hell?
Good.
I've never, got,
fuck,
it, I've never got it below 20. On the...
GG, I entered Ice Caverns with 22.16.
Oh, I mean Dr. Shemp.
That's
finishing it up.
That's record pace. That's not just PB pace. That's leaderboard pace. Well, I'm not thinking about it, guys. I just realized something the other day. And yes, I'm an idiot. Just get it out of the way.
Ooh.
Any PB we get now, because we're breaking our own records, is already leaderboard pace. Literally. Also, GG.
Doing pretty good here.
Also, Lemon.
No, so I've
says,
got to do the rest of
X,
Dr.
Thank
Shin,
you for feeding
and then
Pando.
Do Ice Cavern, and I should be on to Magic Crafter.
I'll show you guys how to set that up if you want it on your stream, because I know we could probably get you a pony lead. Nice. Oh, if you guys need me to help you set up OBS,
yeah,
still, by the way,
I've got some other things in the works.
I have everything written down to help out. Especially if you want to stream in 60 FPS 4K. There we go.
I'll be honest with you now.
Also, 420 told me that there's apparently a skip we can do here in Ice Cavern. As soon as we get the chest, apparently we can just jump off the cliff and it'll take us right to the dragon. Is that right, Chef? Remind me? Sorry. Sincerely sorry for kind of dwelling on it, what happened. It's just, like I said, it's very recent, so I can't get it out of my head very often. Normally I can bounce back from something like this, because, again, I'm unfortunately very used to it. But
it's okay.
There's just more, there's specific details about this specific instance that makes it that much harder. Great, burn. Oh, I like how you could just charge the snowballs, by the way. Exiting Ice Cavern.
Right, entering
I'm
Ice
not,
Cavern.
Not, you're fine. Season. Brittany and I are going to watch for date night tonight a movie called Liar Liar with Jim Carrey. Have you guys ever heard of it?
Of course you would.
I've never seen it, but I've heard of it. Is it a good Jim Carrey movie?
Yeah, I've heard of it.
Nice. Nice.
Oh, yeah.
Classic. Jim Carrey being classic.
Yeah, it really is. Like, nice. It's an early Jim Carrey movie.
Yeah,
it's something you're going to remember Jim Carrey for.
He apparently
for the rest
retired
of your
from
life.
Acting this year.
Man,
I hope they finish Sonic 3 before then, though, because I'm really looking forward to that. Ben Schwartz does a really good job as Sonic.
Yeah.
Also, they're introducing Shadow, which is one of my favorite Sonic characters, so I'm pumped, man. I wonder if they're going to go all in with his broodiness, though.
Probably.
I want a,
nice.
I want
oh,
a Sonic God plush
damn.
Toy. Plush toy from a claw machine a couple of months. There's only one problem. There's only one problem though.
I am behind.
It cost me $5 to get it.
I'm behind.
I was like, it was the only
minutes at a time, actually. God damn. Where did I lose all that time? I'm wondering if I should just ignore the splits, to be honest.
My splits are so fucking fast. It's going to be hard to beat them.
I ignore them. Just whenever you can, just fucking get rid of them. You're just having a good time.
Oh, I do like the only time I run Spyro just lately, in case so. If I did PV, you know, I'd like to have them up there.
Why did Spyro jump off the balloon sideways? I've never seen that before.
Oh yeah,
it's just the way he enters on the balloon. It's however fast you do the balloonist talk.
Speaking of weird things, I noticed when I was practicing yesterday, when I was in Dry Canyon, I fucking saw. Let me get it right. It's like the route when you're on your way towards the castle where you can go to the key jump or fly over to get the key chest. Like a little bit. There's two birds that come at you.
I'm not even gonna lie, I wasn't even trying to get that. That was a complete accident, and I still know. Both of
them were flying on top of each other. Fell off.
Now the thief I have the most trouble with is probably an Alpine Ridge, to be honest.
Come on, Damien. That's it. There you go.
Fuck you! I can't do it!
Oh, he's pissed. Oh, he's easy.
How do you do it? Because I keep fucking up the skip to get him instantly.
I could do that with my eyes closed. Well, basically, what you do is, you know, when you fly down to that bit where the egg thief is, basically, what you want to do is you want to go down right on the edge, wait for the egg thief to finish his animation. When he puts his arms down and go still, charge forward as quick as you can, and as soon as he turns, then flame him as quick as you can.
Got it.
Right on that corner. You've got to be very, very quick though. It's a very tight window.
Oh,
very, very tight.
I get that guy like 95% of the time. Matter of fact, I'm about to go get him right now.
I'll be going to get him very shortly. I'll just come out of Ice Island.
Yep, got him.
All right, let's see what my IVT is going into Magic Crafters. I'd say around the 24-30 range. If it's lower than that, I'll be very surprised. But we'll see.
I got a 2105.
I'm about to tell you what I've got. I've got a... Oh, hang on. I've got a... What?
2456?
2738,
halfway through Alpine.
That's slow. Oh, yeah, I suppose. Oh, I slowed down a bit in Ice Cavern.
Good,
I can see it now. Oh, never mind.
I mentioned it before, but streaming is my happy place. Go. Get Dipper!
You're free.
Alright, you son of a bitch. I saw that.
Oh, crap.
Yep.
Alright, let's do it. Oh, where are you going? There you go.
Sign down. Nice.
Alright, now here's the level that makes and breaks my run. High caves. With a new strat.
You got new strats for Alpine?
Can I get it first try? Or am I going to get it on the second try? Or am I just having... Yeah, I use a slowdown supercharge to get the spiders. It's what all the top runners use. I knew that I had to change it up if I was going to start getting into the top 10.
Shit.
It's a hard strat to learn, but I've been getting pretty consistent at it lately.
Well, by the way, Lee, I tried your you know the spinning top gem near the bottom of Magic Crafters, where the wizard will bring the wall up.
Yeah.
I did this. I fired the spinning top thing at him and it got him.
Oh, nice. Yeah, that strat doesn't always hit. I mean, sometimes the thing doesn't lock on.
He's
actually,
alive.
Most of the time, it doesn't lock on.
He didn't go in the pit. You motherfucker!
Oh, I need to die anyway. It's fine. Fuck you, game.
Oh, yep, I got the strat. Oh, nope, I missed the strat. Damn it. That's okay. Actually, it's not that bad.
The spider so many goddamn second level fucking lies.
Right with the needle movie. Fortune, oh, I'm gonna wait for the fucking fairy. We're gonna have to wait for this fucking fairy. Which is okay, though. I mean, it was still a good attempt. It was a very good attempt.
All I have to say, this is my one and only voice of disappointment. You said wait for him to put his arms down?
I hope I got that.
Damn it, he ran anyway! What the fuck? I didn't even look!
Yeah, wait for him to put his arms down.
I have a personal fucking vendetta against this goddamn thief in particular. Son of a bitch. I hate this fucking stupid goddamn thief.
Yeah, that's a right gym count. Alright, cool dude.
God damn it, I didn't even move near him! Why did he...
Damn it.
Fucker! God damn it! Fuck this stupid fucking thief! I hate that one. So good. No, I totally don't. I don't know where you got that impression.
You don't
impression.
Say. Fable, do you hate that one?
The Alpine Ridge one, man. I got the one in Clifftown. Kinda. Second left. You have to hit that cactus and burn him as he passes it. That's nice. The thing. You can't go between it and the wolf.
That's the wolf.
What do you mean you give? Oh, you do the pro strat. Gotcha.
That's good enough for me.
Yeah, no, I'm not learning it. I'm not learning it.
The top. Yeah, I did the post rep.
Brittany, your thing is done.
I'm doing it my way.
Your shrimp is probably burning, to be honest.
Like Frank Sinatra, like Frank Sinatra said, I do.
My way.
Because
you got it. I just remember the scene from Shrek.
Alpine Ridge, piss easy.
Been out for quite a while now, living off of people you know. There we go. Yeet. Oh, make it! Oh, my God. I don't want to talk
I'm
about
it. I'm literally like a full minute behind my flip. I mean, the IGT is probably looking pretty good still. But RTA is like being mean to me.
All right, we're gonna try to do the wall jump, the wall glide. All right, there we go. Did it first try. Hell yeah! You gotta lightly bump it essentially.
Nice. I was going to say, Fable, what I know, obviously, I'm going to say I'm switching my route back to my old route in high case because I'm feel more confident once I've got, you know, those the gems out of the way first, then I take on the spiders and do the little thing that I do.
You motherfucker.
I still haven't thought of a good name for it, the way I do it. Charming.
Damn it, Spyro, you fucking moron! What the hell? Pissed me off is what he did.
Oh, he done? Shit!
God damn it!
What's he done now?
Not just yet. I mean, when I say toppers, I mean like top 10. Like, you know. I'm talking about like Surf, Narwhal.
Arguably the hardest category, I might add. Damn it! Oh, God. Fucking new strat, fuck me.
In a completely
fucking stupid
different category.
Goddamn. Fucking stupid arch breaking knocked me into the water. God damn it.
Yep. I know exactly what you're talking about.
Fred, what's wrong?
Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
I don't believe you. One, two, three. Please no. Please no. Spyro, go, you fucking moron. Oh god, where's he going? What are we at right now? 36, 4, 21. Okay, that's not bad. That's actually much better than I thought it was. Yeah. Yeah, I know I'm behind. Shut the fuck up, Life Splits. I don't give a shit.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, go ahead, lead. Gaming, sorry.
Okay. No, it's all right. I'm just checking to see where everyone's at.
I'm in Bristol flight. I only have a blowhard to do after this.
That makes no sense, though.
That's my route. I do Alpine, then I do High Caves, then I hit Wizard Peak, go back to Crystal Flight, and then I hit out, or I hit up Blowhard. And apparently I golded Crystal Flight.
Sparrow, dude, come on! Oh, God, he's not even making the simplest jumps now. Purple dinosaur. He wouldn't make a simple fucking jump, and I fell in the lava as a result.
What's he done to you?
Asshole. Oh, shit.
Sorry, man. Keep going, buddy. Keep going, buddy. You got it. Let's all do this together. To the end.
It's not intentional.
Hey, I'm not gonna lie, but I mean, some gamer rage makes for some good tonight. Twitch watch quality.
But I knew if I didn't get back into it, I was never going to.
Right. Right.
It's scary how easily I can cut something off completely.
Let's just get back into into a normal schedule. Oh, I missed it. That's fine.
There we go.
You over here.
What?
Thank you. Give me that. Yeah. All right. Thank you.
Doesn't help that all that's playing on my playlist right now is fucking breakup songs. This is a weird album. Yeah, it's Shinedown.
Sounds it.
You know, I'd answer that question, but I physically don't know.
Oh, crap, one more time. Oh, yeah.
Fuck off, Steve. No one likes you. Keep that damn thing. What one?
You should be singing Lonely. No, I never mind about that one. It's called Lonely by a rat singer called Akon. That's what that egg feet should be singing to himself.
Friend was hot like me.
That's the Pussycat Dolls.
And burn.
Dick.
I'm actually confused how you mix those two up. Should I say
no.
Five?
I wouldn't.
Oh, Beyonce?
Oh, sheesh. I wouldn't say no to the lead singer of the Pussycat Dolls, though.
I didn't know.
Beyonce, you mean Nicole Scherzinger?
Yeah, I never was a fan.
Beyonce is Destiny's Child.
That's a bitch.
God almighty, what's the matter with you, man?
Beyonce.
From what I heard, she is, yeah.
I don't know who Destiny's Child is, but... Yeah,
what?
She's a bitch.
You've never heard of Destiny's Child?
No, I was saying, you know, like it's like a play on words.
I'll give her credit though. She Beyonce's done really well for herself though. She's worked bloody hard. She looks like bloody hard at it.
Damn it. That was close. Spiro, don't do that. Yate. Booyah! Oh, sorry.
Damn,
I got through that without taking a single hit. I'm very happy about that.
1 minute 12.
GG.
Crystal coming out of crystal.
The, if we can nail the new riding,
crystal,
I can get
crystal
110,
flight was 1 minute 12.2.
Nice.
In my
defense,
nice.
That time wasn't my fault though. It was the fucking arch breaking, pushed me into the water.
My riding was
59 seconds. GG.
My route, I'm getting 59 seconds.
Of course. Whoa, Wizard going into Wizard Peak, then I've only got Blowhard to do afterwards. IGT going into Wizard Peak of 30:35.06. Oh, damn. Oh. Jesus.
That's
fast. Especially for me. Damn.
Oh, yeah.
We're gonna play Black Ops Zombies after this.
Not yet.
Yeah, I don't know why, but I've been heavy into Call of Duty. Not the online play, but just friend play and the zombies a lot lately. And also, actually, I know why. When me, Max, Anthony, and Kyler reconnected, that was one of our favorite games to play back when we were in high school. So we started playing that again.
Sounds like. Call
always
Duty
get
zombies,
fucking
like
blowhard on the
Duty
first try.
Handguns.
Always get blowhard first try. Both, you know, all three times you see him, or else you lose time. But I did find out you can jump up and hit him even if he's super high up in that final encounter.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. Okay. We're on PB pace. Holy shit, very barely though.
Take another death.
Make it less. No, no, overshot it, you idiot.
This is a really bad. Really bad time.
Come on.
Ah, there they are. Yep, see these guys. Okay.
Yeah, I'll send you the song later, Gaming. So good. It's called Devastate by Saint Asonia. So fun. Very much classic Rudy's Grace in town.
No?
I got it.
Don't give me the gem skip.
Entering
the gem.
Entering your favorite level.
What's I'm in Wizard Peak, please.
I actually haven't seen that gem glitch a single time since I've been playing like super competitively.
I haven't had it for a while either.
I think that gem glitch only happened for a certain route. We were probably taking the same route at that point when we get the gym glitch.
Oh. Why is there echo? That's me. I know it's me. I just don't know why, because I muted my phone.
I didn't hear it. I don't know who's it, who it is. It's not me.
No gem glitch. Sorry, man. It's a tough one, to be fair.
No gem glitch for me. No, I mean, I didn't.
That's what I was saying.
What I meant was, I didn't. Normally, sometimes I'll get the gem glitch, but I didn't get it. That's what I meant.
Yeah, it's actually good to not have that gem glitch.
Lee, you've changed.
I think. Give me a minute.
Just making a joke. Yeah. It's like you've learned a bunch of stats, and we're just like, you're a completely different person, bro.
What do you mean?
No, you're fine. You're more chill. I noticed that. Because you understand the process a lot more.
Right. Oh. I do. And, like, you know, the more I struggle to get past that 114, the more I can actually appreciate, you know, the faster runs, you know.
Same.
Like, damn. Like, yeah, it's really, I'm really starting to have to put in the work.
It's like, I finally get back into running and streaming again in real life. It's like, hey, guess what? Fuck you. And I'm like, what? It's just a spot of bad luck, isn't it? Shit. Why is that a dead gem? Got it. I gotta speed up. No! Got him. Dead. Okay.
I probably should have grabbed that life.
We're getting there.
Right, blowhard out. Hang on, did I get all the gems? Tell me I got all the gems. Tell me I got all the fuck. No, I didn't. I'm missing. Where the hell are they? Where am I missing 10 gems?
10 gems and
so and close to peeping.
Leaving blowhard. I don't know where the hell I've gone wrong. Now. Where are they?
Yes, yes.
Oh,
gold split on Terrace Village. 39 seconds time save. Fuck yes.
I really missed up Terrace Village.
Songs like this is why I like Adam Guns here. Just listen to those vocals, man. Shut the fuck. Smartest. No!
I can't listen to the vocals.
Piggy.
I think I might know where they are. I'm not sure if it's the right one. Where have they been? Don't tell me they're where I think they are.
I think I'm missing a gem. Because I only have 153 going into wealth. Like,
oh.
Shit!
Found them.
Yeah, it was the key chest. It was the key chest.
Cool. Is it gonna be nice to me today? No. No, it's not. Damn it, Leech, shut up! You fucking chase me, dick.
No.
I don't give a fuck! You don't have a reason to bitch. You
hey,
can
man,
suck and still
nice
be bastard, so shut up. Respectfully, I don't actually mean it, sorry.
I mean, that's true. Because
I know
sucking,
I can do so much fucking better, man.
I'm sucking it up pretty bad right now, I'm not gonna lie.
I know this is for fun, it's just...
I know I can too, but... I know I can too, but at the same time, I'm just vibing today. Like, I've been vibing for the past couple of days, and I don't know, I'm feeling good.
Done.
Those 10 gems that I was missing was in the key chest that I forgot going to get.
Yes! Oh, no, it's green. Fuck, I messed up. I needed to teleport to fucking Terrace Village and then run to fucking...
Alright, go.
There.
B.
Terrace Village.
B.O.B.
Alright.
Shut the fuck up.
I'll be hitting in the treetops.
Yeah,
now.
I got
it. With my new treetop stats. Or straps.
Fuck.
I like the new treetops strats. I don't even have to use that whirlwind on Dragon Island. Just completely skip that shit.
Being a dick.
Alrighty. That
he's being a total dick. And he's proud of it. He's fucking proud of it.
I am being
asshole.
A dick. I'm being a total wiener.
So I need to get sub 50 before we end.
I'm being a total wiener.
I think we're good on that, actually. I'm in Guantan, by the way.
Nice.
Oh, damn, I should check my life
back. There we go. Alright, I had to embrace my fire
for
a second.
Nah,
I'm
not talking about the team.
Okay.
Here.
That's alright.
Very, very fun PC game that's 100% free.
I don't even know what that is.
I love the Half-Life game, so yeah. I also like Left 4 Dead.
I do like Valve. That was good.
They're just a really good company if they can learn how to count to three.
Man, I'm really going to have to get someone to do co-op.
Love that game.
Portal 2 with me.
I'm
no
down
shit.
As well. If I can get hold of it.
Hi,
oh, I said if I had to, I'd just like I'm not sure if there's a way you can gift on Xbox. Matter of fact, I actually have a hard copy of it somewhere around here in the house. I might just overseas mail it to you.
Oh, that'll be good. That'd be nice.
Enter Guantan with perfect sparks. Oh my god.
I mean, it would be cheaper for me, you know, like, I won't actually
exiting.
Have to,
sorry, exiting Guantan with perfect sparks. Didn't take a single hit. Oh my god, that's awesome.
That's
nice.
I'm
just making my way.
Making my way downtown. Walking fast.
I know that song, it's just I've heard it too many times. I grew up in that era.
Gaming triggered it for me.
How old are you?
No, I did too.
Oh yeah, fair enough. 27. Everybody thinks I'm in my 30s though.
2023?
Just
because I'm 33
like,
years
should
old.
I take that as a compliment? Because to me, that sounds like they aged me.
It's bad. Now, you know you're starting to get old.
Oh, God. Don't remind me. Someone
you know
reminded me the other day of the GameCube. One of my very first consoles
is
over 20 years old now. He's caseworker. What?
Yep, I remember back in my day, the only gaming cube we had was when we played Foursquare in the corner.
What's up?
Oh shit, I about didn't get that dragon.
Hello. In the middle of the street. Okay, never mind. Then. Nope, I lost the PB because of that. God damn it. My caseworker called and I don't know what about. I'm hoping everything is okay, but she didn't answer when I answered, so I don't know. Well, I think it's about the bus pass.
More PBs will come.
Yeah.
She's really cool about it. It's like, hey, you need to get around. Here's your bus pass. So I've been getting around. Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck! Who's on PB pace? Damn it! Okay, I can't
fucking
fuck
banana. I was trying to race it to the top, but I.
I just finished. No, you guys are ahead of me, way ahead of me.
Mine's the best.
Well, don't forget, our loading screens are a lot faster.
It's up there with the PS5 performance-wise, hey, so I can believe it.
No,
it's its only competition, if I remember correctly.
Tell you that much.
If, when I get a PC eventually, I'll be coming for your PC time. Well, once I get a PC version of this, I promise you. Right, get in there.
How did that chicken not get blown up with the fucking fireworks, Jeff?
Did you forget to order original recipe or extra
KFC?
Crispy?
Oh, I love me some extra crispy, man. 100%.
Nah.
Original recipe?
Yeah,
of course.
KFC.
Original recipe.
I'm addicted
to
the pain that I've
It's what I grew up with. It's what I like and it's what I grew up with. So shut up. I tried extra crispy.
I can hear you, gaming. Don't worry.
What's this name? Well, there was it, but I've tried extra crispy once. The crunchy bits got stuck up, nearly hurt my bloody teeth. They nearly got stuck in my teeth. I was like, no, thank you.
I have super sensitive teeth. So yeah, it does suck because I know how extra crispy tastes and how
teeth?
It feels when you have good teeth, and it's fucking amazing.
God damn, man, I missed it.
Yeah, I know, me neither, apparently. I do, like, I miss being able to bite down into an apple. Like an unpeeled apple, like just straight fresh and washed in the sink. But now I have to slice that shit up.
come on, break! God damn it, come on. Yeah. Yes. Damn it. I'm missing any gems and tree tops.
Oh,
I really don't care. I'm fucking rushing now. Bullshit, that's when I become Speedy Boy.
Yeah, whatever you do, try not to rush. That's when you start to miss things.
Yeah.
Just saying. A little. You know, like,
nothing about
Spyro 2 and Grace of Fighting. I mean, I am only in the top 15. What do I know?
Oh, shut up, you. Always got you there.
Do it. I need a competition.
Just for that, I'm going to learn.
Brando's going to kill himself if he runs it as often as I do.
Bring it on.
I don't mean as in, like, suicide. I mean, he's literally going to run himself ragged. It is a brutal category. Yeah.
Oh, God, this is...
I never ever want to disrespect Brando. He's an awesome.
I know what you mean.
That's how I know I've been down. I haven't even been popping into his streams lately.
I'll only run it.
That's how I know something's wrong. It's like I don't even watch Game Grumps or anything anymore. It's just one of my favorite channels. It's like, geez, man. Right back. Just bring by the bus pass.
Oh, I bet this is gonna be like a 1 hour run. Or no, not a 1 hour run. I bet it's gonna be like 51 minutes.
Damn it, I'm behind! Fuck!
Nope, still sub 50 minutes.
Come on, man! I was like, don't run off the cliff, stupid. Everything in creation is trying to stop me for some reason. Including our child. What is he doing? He's looking at you. Why'd you close the door? Oh, yeah. No, you're not supposed to go in there, Jed. The Cattler box is in the kitchen now. I'm not okay with it, to be honest, but it's literally all we have right now. And Janesh is a prick. We didn't get a landlord, we got a slumlord. There's a difference. No, I am not going to Dreamweavers, you fucking dickhead. I lost a full minute last time because I accidentally clicked yes. God, that was bullshit. Never told you out anything. But because of you and me, I'm still in love. There we go. Alright, entering Metalhead with 54 minutes.
I'm just in. Nice. Guan, about to go to the prison room in Guan Song where the young frogs are. Let's go. Get them. Ah, you bastard. Right past me. I like the way it's doing. Ah, got stabbed by one of the dudes. And another one. Hey, get out of it. I don't think so. Right, you're dead as well.
Right,
only took two hits. Not bad. I've only got green sparks. Where am I going? Oh yeah. There we go. Hey, come here. Move it. Come on, Spire, move it. And jump. Go that slow again, I'll have to kick your ass.
Oh, you didn't drop the
gem.
I'm gonna
kick your
wife.
Sideways.
There it is.
I'm gonna kick it.
Shit, that's a good hang kill. That's a really good hang kill. Holy shit.
Oh god, it hurts my heart.
Let's do it, Hank Hill.
What was that?
Mean. There's not a mean bone in Hank Hill's body, Hank Hill, are you kidding impression. Me?
Oh, let's,
right.
Oh, let's hear it. I didn't quite.
When he's mean to Bobby. Oh no, god,
yeah.
So it looks like Metalhead glitched into the wall. I've never seen that before. That's great. It'll fucking take a hit.
Get out of Misty Bog. I don't know where that one was going.
Mm-hmm. Audio Slave. Very good band. Very underrated as well.
Are you listening to Chris Cornell?
Like Audio Slave. You don't like any bands. Fuck off.
I do not either.
Oh, come on.
Hey, I love
those. Those are so generic bands, man.
And Megadeth.
To a place I recall.
And Pantera.
I was there.
Here we go. Here we go again.
Long ago, the sky was bruised. The world was red. And there you led me on. What the fuck is going on with Jet? Brett. Brett! For God's sakes, woman, take up the damn headphones. What is going on with Jet? Let him in the fucking bathroom. I don't care anymore. Yes! Also, we are literally missing a two that I don't know where it is. Guys, I'm about to throw this fucking run. I'm done. I'm so tired of Sparks not wanting to pick up gems. Where is it, Sparks? Fuck, it's all the way at the beginning of the fucking level. God damn it.
Where is it, boy? Sniff it out. And
that's what I did.
In that case, quit the game and come right back into the same save file.
Yeah.
That way you'll re-enter the level at the very beginning, and you won't have to, travel.
Damn it!
Yeah.
No, it probably dropped it, but it probably glitched out. Yeah, that happens all the time in Metalhead.
I was ahead then! No, apparently it's somewhere up in the rafters or something.
Yeah, super
what the
careful.
Hell? Man, I don't care. Fuck it. Just don't fucking care.
Just keep it going. Get a run in.
Yeah.
Exactly. It's just a game.
Bullshit.
And plus, you're chilling with us.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
We're all having a good time. I'm actually enjoying the conversation more than I'm enjoying Spyro right now.
I wish I could say the same, but I honestly don't know what
the actually helping me.
Really? Oh god. Oh, it was in the doorway. It was in the fucking doorway, and Sparks just decided not to pick it up. God damn it! Yeah, of course I didn't get sub one out, or fuck you! Damn it! Of course the song will play.
Oh crap. Yeah. Up.
like, I'm not a violent man, but all I can think about right now is screaming until my voice goes hoarse, punching a hole in my fucking computer. Not because I'm angry, but just to get those fucking emotions out somehow. Because it's hard being strong, trying to be strong 24/7, when life keeps trying to stab me in the fucking back, man.
Yeah. I might have a suggestion for you, my man.
No.
Do you have like a local gym you go to?
5 miles away.
Where's the nearest gym? Roughly. I would say sign up to your local gym, take boxing lessons. Try that. Especially when you've got to use the gym to start hit the bags and buddy punch the living fuck out of them.
It sucks being the older sibling.
Right, IGT going into Dreamweaver's 5730.
You can't let those emotions out. You have to stay strong so that they can mourn, so they can heal. It sucks. But I do it again. I do it any time in a heartbeat so that they can have some peace.
Yeah.
It's worth it, honestly. It just sucks. Troll got me.
Oh, get here. Thank you.
This part of me can't accept it.
Where is everybody?
I just left Lofty. I'm about to head into Jacques.
I'm just currently in Haunted Towers right now.
I am, however, still 3 minutes behind, on RTA at least.
5 minutes behind.
I didn't even have a pee break.
Five.
And I'm that far behind. Mm. Damn, 9 minutes?
It's only five, but it feels like 9 minutes.
I was about to say, damn, 9 minutes. Like, what the fuck?
Hmm.
Yeah, I know. 3 minutes behind.
Yeah, what
me
I was doing
for
first.
Eternity.
That's for the husband. Sometimes goodbye is a second chance.
Make it. Thank you. Give me that. God's sake. Hey, Gits. Come on, Spot.
I'm starting, I think, Lofty Castle. My splits are all fucked.
Little bastard, Spot.
Yeah, Lofty Castle. At least this one's important. What's up, man?
Hello,
basically,
hey, Brett.
I could.
That fucking cunt.
Boom. Oh, shit. What's that? Oh, sorry. It's okay to miss James when we're just having a chill run. Even I miss gems as well, so you're not alone there. I miss some earlier, as you well know. It's all good.
Itchy stomach. Yeah, itchy stomach. My burn score on my stomach gets a little itchy around the waistline from time to time.
Okay. What was you about to say before that?
Oh, I was saying entering Nasty's world at 107.12.
I'm nowhere near Nasty's world yet. I've only just got out of Haunted Towers.
Matter of fact, I'm gonna go ahead and collect everything here.
Oh, come on.
Split
Green Weavers.
I'm not going to save these splits anyway, so it's all good. Matter of fact, I don't even know why I have them running anymore. The run's dead, so I should literally just close out the split so that they're stopped trolling me.
Yeah, just close them out, mate, because my friend, because that's what's getting to you. That's why I don't have them. I'll have a go with them. I'll go.
I do like them. I do like my splits. My splits, literally, if I'm to beat my splits, I literally have to be on PB pace. And that's kind of what I like about them, because if I do like in my head, like a minute on my splits, then I know that I'm like right on the verge.
Mm.
It keeps me informed, you know.
Like that little bit of reassurance that you're either doing well or you're playing pretty shite, as we say.
Oh yeah. Yep, don't get caught up in that explosion. Oh, fuck that. That's some bullshit if I ever saw a bull in a pasture.
It hurt my head.
What happened?
I have no idea. I just came up with it on the fly. my cousin, before he passed, he had this saying. What it means is if it's not one thing, it's the other. But he would say it as if it's not chickens, it's feathers. That was his go-to thing, and I like that. Oh, how does that not hit that guy?
Oops, shit. I think my run's fucking dead for a PB.
I was thinking for dead for a PB.
I need it to be around about the 116 range when I hit. If I go into like Nasty's well with a 116 IGT, then that's when I'll think about it. But if it's over that, if it's like 117.
Oh, what the fuck is going on here? All the gems are invisible as well. Okay, never mind. They're there.
Yeah.
I had some weird-ass glitch that I've never seen before. They apparently didn't load or something like that. It probably has to do with the death abuse that I just took. And where I spawned at. Oh, yep, I'm done here.
Oh shit, I've been killed in fucking Dark Passage. Fuck it out. First time. Damn.
Lots of first times happening in this I walk a lonely road, the
only one that I have ever known. Oh, they still were kind enough to put you to respawn me where I wanted him to, where I want it to be, so that's not too bad.
Now, how does that gold? I mean, I'm 3 minutes behind, but I'm still golding. I don't understand splits. I don't know how they work. I don't know how they think. I am like on a 117 or 118 pace, though. So. Ah! Oh. 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 Alright, I'm gonna try these green gems. Why not?
First person that tells me I'm in their prayers, I'm gonna tell them their god can go kill himself and I'd be nothing. conceited, racist, sexist piece of xenophobic garbage. Judeo-Christian God is a monster by definition. Now that's fucking religions existed for so long with that as their deity. I will never understand. I understand the religion is about peace, but that deity is a fucking monster.
Beats me.
Leviticus is all about how the Judeo-Christian God wiped us off the face of the earth because he was bored with us. I'm not gonna lie, Merritt. With all the tragedies lately, I'm like 10 seconds from becoming a fucking atheist. Because I fail to understand how people can believe in a deity that would allow children to die so fucking young. People try to use the free will argument. It's like, that's bullshit. For instance, the pedophilic priests that are still walking free despite being exposed.
Oh, no, not just that. I'm literally talking about, I guess I was out alive. That's fine. But no, I was like... No, I was just thinking, let's see. If God has a plan for
that's the other thing. There's like so much hypocrisy in Christianity. It's like, Jesus died for your sins, so you would never risk going to hell. Really? Then why does it still exist? Why do people still use it as a scapegoat to keep people in line like sheep to slaughter? Why is everything in the Bible stolen from a different religion?
No, don't hit me! Damn it. This is the longest
nitpickiness towards the specifics, I still respect those who use it for peace. And who use it for unity. They have my love and respect.
Take it the long way.
Right, just Lofty Castle and Jack
today. Oh, God, I missed the fucking God's job.
I hate Lofty Castle, I hate it.
I'm not even archiving this stream, man. Is this fucking Black... or, MCR?
Oh god, this went was a from 117 a 120 pace to a 218 pace. To a 215. It's probably now a 120, 121.
Yeah, fuck off, MCR. I don't like that, man. They suck.
Can I get up on that thing?
There, how about Foo Fighters? That's better. Bear.
I really gotta pee, too. That's making it much harder on me.
Well, you know you're not going to beat PB, so go for it, go pee.
Yeah, I know, but at the same time, I'm like super stubborn. I want to finish the run before I have to go relieve myself. Oh God, yeah. I am now officially 5.5 minutes behind my RTA.
I hate Lofty Castle.
I do too. I'm actually pretty good at Lofty Castle now, but I still hate how long it is.
So fucking
most of the last ones are, honestly.
It is a long ass level.
At least that one goes by quick, though, because it's pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
But fucking
Dark Passage is a long-ass one as well.
Yeah. Gnor Twilight Harbor, though.
It's a link.
It is bullshit, the precision of that fucker that throws the barrels at you. Not the one who throws them overhead, but the one that hits you and then poses afterwards. That fucking... His pinpoint accuracy is fucking bullshit.
Oh, yeah, I know which one you're talking about.
Oh, God, yeah. Oh, he used to get me all the time, he did.
Believe it or not, the music wasn't even making me feel worse, it's just... So much realization's happening as I'm focusing on the drawings, those deep in thought, and I just realized, it's like... I haven't gone more than like a month without losing someone I care about.
You need someone to privately talk to, DFABLE, at some of the other days. Let me know. No problem. Anytime. You've helped me a lot. At least. Well, that's why I'm offering to give a little bit back.
That's like the worst part is, I know for a fact no one's going to tell me about the funeral. Because it was like pulling teeth trying to get information about Lamont when he was murdered. People question why I obsessively hate Black Lives Matter as a movement. Not the idea, it's a beautiful idea on paper. But actually look at the past few years for me, and you'll understand completely. Every single one of my friends I lost the past few years were to an issue that BLM openly said didn't exist. That when they were pleaded to for assistance, they were ignored. Because BLM didn't think it was worth their time. No joke, if I met the founders, I'd knock their teeth down their fucking throat.
Oh shit, I always shot the fucking... Sorry.
Shove a paper down the throat of everyone who has died to that issue that they decided didn't matter.
This is not good.
Damn. 80% of the fatality rate of African Americans every year is due to street violence. And it's completely fucking ignored. And I lost my best friend to it. Two of them. Lamont and Harry.
Yeah.
And when BLM, when we went to BLM for support, they said it wasn't a real issue. When thousands of black families went to them for support, they said it wasn't a real issue.
Yes, it was.
Then the very next day, I see SGDQ doing a fundraiser for BLM. I almost fucking screamed. Like I said, the protesters have my respect. They want change. But the founders, I hope they rot in the deepest pit of hell. And I want to witness it happen. Well, it's like there's a fat Jewish billionaire who owns
Beale. That's
where the money's going.
That money.
So it's not even like... It's not even like it's their own brand or anything they actually put together for their communities. No, they got funding by this Jewish billionaire dude, and everything BLM related is owned by him. All the flags you see, all the fucking, you know, shirts, that's all him. Yep. Yet the irony is he's so out of touch that when the issue was actually brought to him, he didn't even know about it. He didn't know the specifics about it. And that's not, you know, having a benefactor is not a problem. But if it's to the point that none of the money that's supposed to be going towards a good cause actually reaches the good cause, then you're not helping, you're making things worse. So, like, not okay, to be honest. It'd be so easy to say fuck empathy and fuck compassion and just be angry all the time to avoid feeling depression and pain. We can never do that. We'd be letting down so many people that care about us and that look to us for strength. I can't do that. As easy as it would be for me to fucking be a stone cold motherfucker, go full blown sociopath, and literally tell everyone I love to go fuck themselves and feel nothing. It's not the answer. And I have to consistently tell myself that every fucking time. Because as fucked up as it sounds, the fact that you're feeling pain actually is a good thing. It means they were a good person. Yeah. It means they meant something to you. But it's so easy. Mm. It would be so easy to just flip that switch, but you'd never come back from it. And let me tell you, man, using anger to get over depression is a trap. That's how people become abusive. I'm trying, like, damn, it's not good.
Yeah, that's definitely not the answer. But I feel because depression and anger come hand in hand. No, you're fine, man. I mean, it's still fresh on your brain.
Back when I went through breakups,
we got you back.
Back in the day, I had to go through it alone. I would have been.
I mean, you're probably.
We're not a band. We're not there, a band of you, no matter what happens in this day and age. Fuck that. We're both boys, we look after each other.
That wasn't my intent. It's just when I think about the specific ideas of the deity himself, you know, it's like there's a lot of questions.
No, ask me that.
No, I know.
But if anything, like a bright way to look at it is, it makes it even more incredible that Christians use the religion for unity and peace, despite that being what their deity is. That makes it even more incredible, honestly. Because that means they took something that was intrinsically seen as wrong, you know, intrinsically as the cause of a lot of historical stuff, and they turned it into something positive to bring unity. That's beautiful. Yeah.
It is. I mean, there are some great Christians out there.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get me wrong. And I think the best Christian out there is the one that doesn't try to push it on you. Like, hey, man, like, look, I'll sit down with you and I'll talk to you about my beliefs for a little bit. You can either hear me or you can say, hey,
yeah,
whatever, you know, and we'll go our separate ways and we'll have a beer together, you know. Like I know my religion. I'm comfortable with it. Just like, you know, people say I know my sexuality and I'm comfortable with it, you know. Like, just be cool about it. That's all you have to do. But like my aunt the other day.
I'm worried about yours, like, if you feel the need to judge me about not being the same as you. That's what I would say.
I'm like, really? You're gonna. Well, exactly, and I was like, I know you want to get this off your chest because it's apparently been weighing on her. And I love my aunt because she's been like a second mother to me.
Yeah.
And she means well, but she comes off very pushy and very judgy, you know, sometimes. But she's a great person. She's just terrible at managing her religion, you know, to other people. And she's not even a Christian.
Presbyterian.
Oh, yeah, she's like a, I think that's like what that half breed of half Jew, half Christian. No, it's not that. It's like a. It's weird. Like, she celebrates Hanukkah.
Yeah.
But she still believes in Jesus. There's an actual term for it. I don't understand. She doesn't like eat pork or anything like that, or nothing that's not kosher.
Yeah.
So it's like very Jewish, but she's also very Christian. It's weird. But at the same time, I told her, like, look, Beck, like, just because you're over here right now and, like, you're trying to get me to repent right now doesn't mean I'm going to instantly hear what you're saying and repent right now. Like, if I ever do repent and, like I just, like, suddenly have the need to have religion in my life and have to fall to my knees, break down, and have that moment, that's going to come when it comes to me. It's not going to happen just because you're having a conversation with me.
Right, heading into Nasty's world with a 118.23. Jesus, I'm about 2 minutes slow. Oh dear.
Yeah, you don't want to know how far behind I am.
Well, you know what I'm going to be doing the next couple of days?
My current in-game time is 129.53, well, and I'm just now playing for one. Yeah, I'm not even getting the sub 130 this time.
In Nork as well.
Yeah.
I'm not even going to get a sub 130 either.
Hey, I barely got a sub 120. I'm staring at a 119.56 right now.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, literally, sub 120 is a bad run for me. I get it. I'm fast, but
come on, Fable. Let's finish this.
There's at least 13 like other people that are way faster than I am.
The series. I'm almost done, so I'll say the name in a minute. But I'm excited about starting the series. We'll be starting Monday because it's a game I'm very close to platinuming right now in my free time. So I'm really excited to do that on stream instead of in my free time, because I haven't platinumed the game live in a long time. Like, you, by the way, I don't know if I've ever mentioned this, but if you go to my YouTube right now, the playthroughs where I platinumed all of the games I platinumed are all on my channels. I did it all live. I did it for Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, Final Mix 2, and 3, Bloodborne, Dark Souls 1, Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 3, Bloodborne DLC, Dark Souls 3's DLC.
Oh.
Yeah, no, I missed the jump
to Jacques.
When you get to that last section, I missed that long jump. No, I finished Jacques. I'm finishing up Nessie's food.
You're still in Jacques? Ah, okay.
Despite this being one of the worst runs I've done as far as one in a long time, it still wasn't that bad. So we're only in the 130s. Yeah, it is right. Exactly 134.
I mean, it's still right around your PB. Yeah. I mean,
done.
I mean,
there we go. There you go. GG. We won. GG.
GG. GG, man.
I did.
Oh, cool. GG.
GG lead.
Yeah, I've been sitting here for probably about 15 minutes.
Well, what was your IGT lead?
119.
While you finish up, I'm going to go use the rest.
I'm going to be a little bit. I'm just about to go into. Right, hold on. All right, come on, let's get strong.
Yeah, I'm heading over to your channel now, gaming. This
will be the first run that I've fully completed in a few days. Because of my mental block, I just keep on starting the stream, keep fucking up and just stopping it.
No, I feel you. But hey, you got a full rundown. You know, that's what matters, right?
Oh, yeah. I think what I'm thinking of doing is do a run, start doing runs where, but changing the skin colour each time. So I'll do this one in green and the next one down, I'll do and then do it in that colour, and I just died again. So I'll do this one in green, then the next colour down, then the next colour down, then the next colour down after that. I think there's one more after that, and then the last time I do it will be Spyro in his original skin.
Right.
Kind of figured.
I like how you two just have like completely different opinions on how dark and how light it is outside. I'm glad you don't see colors like that.
There we go. Alright, now what? I can watch you run. Had to open up multi-twitch again. I'm back. Thank you. As for the series, I'll be streaming starting Monday. It will be Rayman Legends, which is a collection of all the newer Rayman games in one game, because it lets you play all the levels from the previous game.
Ooh.
It's a very long game, so it's a nice kind of lengthy playthrough. Like I said, I've almost platinumed it already.
Rayman.
So Rayman is a very Legends. Famous French game.
PS2 game.
About this kind of weirdly disfigured cartoon character game.
I know who Rayman is. I used to play it when I was a kid, but I've never heard. I wasn't quite sure if I yeah.
So you don't take the death for the easy teleport then?
Shit! I bloody forgot. Hang on, did I get? Oh, I'm fucking up there bad. I'm supposed to have buddy put the drawbridge. I was supposed to be going up top.
Gotcha.
There we go.
Yeah, gaming doesn't do the death abuse yet.
Death abuse is more useful on console than it is on PC, because live shit still keeps going even when you're dead. So you're still losing time.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, if you're running on PC, there are
There's definitely a different route for certain things and different death abuses.
Did not mean to do how I normally do that, but I hope.
Oh, I should go ahead and cut off my Xbox. Let it rest for a little bit. Because I am not done.
I might, honestly.
I have a feeling I'm going to get right back in. Oh, wait. Shit. I need to.
No, tomorrow I've got to get back into SSX/ Super Mario Sunshine practice. And then Sunday, obviously, no streams. Oh. And then Monday, finally, start Rayman.
All right.
Mine was flawless.
My Twilight Harbor was horrible. I died like three times.
Mine was flawless. Like, I took a couple hits, but I still managed to get through it without dying a single time.
My Twilight was fucking disgusting.
You know, other than, you know, death abuses. Thank you. No, what fucked me was, Jacques and Lofty Towers.
Yeah.
Not Lofty Towers, Haunted Towers. That's where I lost the big time.
I need Spark. Spark. Oh, I need. There we go. That's what I needed. What's my IGT? 126, 20.
Metalhead cost me about 3 minutes.
Not sure. No, this might be a 132, I reckon.
Because it turns out that gym was just in the archway right after you fight Metalhead, and just Sparks just didn't want to pick it up. Yeah, so I wasted 3 minutes looking around that level for it, so yeah.
Oh, I got you.
Alright, nasty knock. Let's finish this bastard.
Yeah, let's go ahead and watch.
So I can get a shower.
Let's go ahead and watch. Game and finish his run. No, we're not saving the splits. Fuck you.
I nearly had him there.
Yeah, if you turn to the right just a little bit, you can pretty much nail him when you hit the flame.
I'll get him in a second. Damn. I'll get him here though. I think he goes a little bit too wide here. Goes a little bit too wide, that's why I get him. This one is.
I hit this guy on the second corner. Like, not here, but. You always get him a lot earlier than I get him.
So they can see if it's up here. Special support note. I would raise, but you're literally about to end the screen, so. This is just a different way of supporting. You do the one in
half. That's good enough for me. I'll take that.
You didn't have one in your stream either. When I started to break down, all my viewers went from like 9 to 0. So I was trying to stay mellow, but yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
I
mean, all the cool people that, you know, normally come in, you know, came in and said hi, good luck, and all that stuff. But it is the weekend, so people have things they gotta do, you know. Or, not that they gotta do, but, you know, things they wanna do.
Yeah.
Alright, Thorn Trap popped in for the first time in a while, said hi. Good
luck.
Damn. Oh, and, come on. Get up. I'm
blocked. Like, I would practice, but that's another 2 hours wasted if I do. And
no, I'll be practicing tomorrow, but I'm not gonna be I'm not gonna be streaming. Hell no. Saturdays is where I do a bit of cooking. Well, a tiny little bit. I need some chicken wings, but yeah, it's my turn. It's on with my sauce, my secret sauce that I make. Secret sticky barbecue sauce, then, if you will. How's that about? Has that cleared up a little bit?
Oh, it's not in the race. Whoops.
Yeah, there you go, then.
I've got an amazing North Carolina barbecue sauce. And I think I put like 2 cups of apple cider vinegar, 1 cup of ketchup.
Getting big.
Put in all the spices, some lemon wedges. Bring that up to a small boil. Stir it up.
Got this.
Right,
take out the lemon wedges and bottle it up.
Right, nasty's yeah. Loot. Nasty's loot. What the? Right. As Dayo Man what? Would say, rev up the diddles. rev up those diddles. Because people have diddles in his chat, in Diamond's chat. Right, what have we got here? Let's have a look at the IGT. 128.50. Sub 132?
I mean, I got 130, so. Or 134, so you're definitely.
Yeah, kitty, I'm letting you out of your cage.
You can do the high skip, huh? And now I can't either. Apparently, it's harder on PlayStation controllers, so that's why I'm like.
No.
I have to take a data.
I'm not.
Actually, I've heard that it's harder on Xbox controllers, but that came from a PlayStation player. I'm actually pretty sure it's harder on PlayStation, because Xbox controller is very easy. You just, it's like on Xbox, you very slightly pull down on the analog stick, on the left analog stick, just enough to get him to where he's starting to arch up. And as soon as you get the angle you want, you hit up on the D-pad and just hold it. And you had to hold both of them. You had to hold both the analog stick and the D-pad at the same time. And that's how you do height cap on Xbox. On PlayStation, however, you have to hit up on the analog stick, like slightly up on the analog stick, and then you hit down on the D-pad. And once you hit the angle that you want on the D-pad, you just let go of the D-pad.
Interesting.
And you should maintain the angle of flying upward.
I thought that plane feet was gonna zoom past me. Yeah.
Matter of fact, Fable, if you go to Narwhal's YouTube channel, he actually has a video of him with the controller in his hand, you know, showing how to do it, since you're playing on a PlayStation controller. I don't know why it's so different for the two controllers. As a matter of fact, it might even, for all I know, you could probably do it the same way on both controllers. Don't quote me on that. There's probably some excellent Spyro runner lurking in the background. It's like, nah, that's some bullshit right there.
Give me a second, gentlemen. Got him. That's why I needed to get in.
Maybe go back to the messages and give me a port because it should be a skip in this part where you can just get the plane before you can fly down. It's a frame perfect plane though, so I need to just practice it.
Yeah, it's very frame perfect. As a matter of fact, it would be easier for you to learn height cap than it would to do that early plane skip. I guarantee it.
Yep, 950 going into the treasure room.
Got it. There you go. GG. GG.
Stand by.
See what you got. I think you got sub 132. Oh,
done.
GG, everybody. There you go.
I get him.
Fuck off.
Correct me up. Bleed was saying something yesterday dragons. That it was a conspiracy that the dragon at the beginning is just kind of a shit.
Well, enough for you for one day.
Because he was talking shit about Gnork, which is why he attacked in the first place. And I'm like, you know what? There's some truth to that. Yeah,
you know what? He was shit talking Nork at the beginning. I think that was to antagonize him. And do you notice he's an artisan, but all he does is wear clocks. What's right, really arty? What's arty about that?
GG.
Alright, here we go. We
hey, that's, what it, that's actually an exact record.
132.06. Never mind.
Not bad.
I'm still coming to get your ass. For both bloody PC and console.
GG.
You better believe it. I will eventually. Right. See how long it. Don't know how long it's going to take me to do it. There you go. Right. Right. Let me just sort this out real quick. Come on. That's it. There we go.
Yeah, with you guys was fun, but everything.
And
else
you. Gonna end the stream. I need to end it.
Right.